فؤادك الأيام فتى.
نعم.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده على ما له من الأسماء الحسنى.
The author رحمه الله, he started his book with the basmala. He said بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم, which basically is in the name of Allah, the most merciful, the most gracious. And to start with the basmala, it goes hand in hand with exactly what the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to do when he used to write his letters to the leaders. Hafiz ibn Hajar, his kitab Fathul Bari, which I'm reading from, Hafiz says, because Imam al-Bukhari, he didn't start his book with alhamdulillah. Imam al-Bukhari started his book straight away by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and then straight away he went to Kitabu Bad al-Wahi. He spoke about the revelation and how the revelation started. So Hafiz ibn Hajar is explaining why Imam al-Bukhari didn't start with the Basmala and Alhamdala. So he says, وَيُؤَيِّدُهُ أَيْضًا وُقُوعُ كُتُبِ رَسُولِ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ إِلَى الْمُلُوكِ وَكُتُبِهِ فِي الْقَضَايَا مُفْتَتَحَةً بِالتَّسْمِيَةِ دُونَ حَمْدَلَةٍ وَغَيْرِهَا كَمَا سَيَأْتِي فِي حَدِيثِ أَبِي سُفْيَانَ فِي قِصَّةِ هِرَقْلَ فِي هَذَا الْبَابِ وَكَمَا سَيَأْتِي فِي حَدِيثِ البرائي في قصة السهيل بن عمرو في صلح الحديبية وغير ذلك من الأحاديث. What supports Imam al-Bukhari in starting with the basmala is the fact that the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his letters that he used to write, the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam to the leaders, he would start it with the basmala, and his books in which he used to write about general matters, he would say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, and he wouldn't say the hamdala. Also, in the hadith that's going to come later, which is the hadith of Hiraqli, Azim al-Rum, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started the letter with Bismillah when he sent it to him. Also, the hadith of Bara, which is the story of Suhail ibn Amr, Sulh al-Hudaybiyah, the treat of Hudaybiyah, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he started his letter by saying Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. So when you're writing a letter, to say Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim is the sunnah. When you're given a khutbah, what's the sunnah? When you're given a khutbah, half of it goes on to saying, وَهَذَا يُشْعِرُ بِأَنَّ اللَّفْظَ الْحَمْدِ وَالشَّهَادَةِ إِنَّمَا يُحْتَاجُ إِلَيْهِ فِي الْخُطَابِ دُونَ الرَّسَائِلِ وَالْوَثَائِقِ. That the hamdala, to say إِنَّ الْحَمْدَ لِلَّهِ, and to come with the shahada, it is done when you're given a sermon, a Friday khutbah to Jum'ah, or you're given a reminder, دون الرسائل, not when you're writing letters. So that's why Imam al-Bukhari rahimahullah, Imam al-Bukhari, he didn't start his sahih with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Naam. And then the Sheikh said, Alhamdulillahi. Alhamdu, what does it mean? Hamd means, it means to praise Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. To praise him with what? With the great characteristics which he has, subhanahu wa ta'ala. So pay attention here, brothers and sisters. The author, he said, Alhamdu. Alhamdu is a noun. How do we know it's a noun? Because it has one of the signs you can identify a noun, which is alif and lam. So he said, Alhamdu. Praises to Allah. Lillahi, to Allah, right? And then after that, he said, Nahmaduhu. He brought it as a verb. So first he brought it as a noun, and then after that he brought it as a verb. Why? The verb has a meaning, which is istimrar wa dawam. The verb benefits that it's still consistent and it's still going on. So my praise to Allah is still going on. For what? Ala ma lahu min al asma'il husna. Because of Allah, his great names. And this goes hand in hand in the verse in Surah Al-A'raf, ayah 180, where Allah says, وَلِلَّهِ الْأَسْمَاءُ الْحُسْنَى. Allah has great names. فَدْعُوهُ بِهَا, call unto Allah by those names. Also the hadith where the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, إِنَّ لِلَّهِ, Allah has 99 asman. Allah has 99 names. إِلَّا وَاحِدًا. Allah has 99 names. إِنَّ لِلَّهِ تِسْعَةً وَتِسْعِينَ اسْمًا مِئَةً إِلَّا وَاحِدًا مَنْ أَحْصَاهَا دَخَلَ الْجَنَّةِ. Anybody who implements it, lives by it, memorizes it, will enter Jannah. Bukhari al-Muslim narrated that hadith من حديث أبي هريرة. نعم.
والصفات الكاملة العليا.
And Allah تبارك وتعالى, He has characteristics. Those names of Allah, there are characteristics that are in it, that are complete and that are high. كاملة means what? Complete. العليا means high. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He has what? Those 99 names that we know. And there are more. Because Allah says, the Prophet said in the hadith, because Allah's names are more than 99, based on the hadith of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, سميت به نفسك أو أنزلته في كتابك أو علمته أحد من خلقك أو استأثرت به في علم الغيب عندك. There's names which Allah kept back. All of those names, there are characteristics that are in them. We affirm those characteristics for Allah. How do we affirm them? من غير تحريف ولا تكييف ولا تمثيل ولا تعطيل. We affirm those characteristics for Allah without, number one, distorting it, without giving it a how. Two, number three, without resembling it to the creation. And four, without dismantling it. ولا تعطيل. Without dismantling it. نعم.
وعلى أحكامه القدرية العامة لكل مكون وموجود.
And Allah is praised, subhanahu wa ta'ala, for what? على أحكامه. So Sheikh is saying, the wow is still connected to what? يعني نحمد الله means we praise Allah. It's still connected to the verb نحمد. And we praise him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. جل وعلا. We praise him for what? Also, على أحكامه القدرية. We praise him for his predestined rulings. أحكام حكم which are قدري. That he predestined, subhanahu wa ta'ala. This universe that we see today are what? They are mutasarrif. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala controls it how he wills. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he is also what? He is ghani. He is rich. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. From everything, he's rich from it. And they are what? And they are in need of him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah, he raises whoever he wills. Allah, he what? يُعِزُّ مَنْ يَشَاءُ. He honors whoever he wills. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yudhillu man yasha. He humiliates whoever he wills. Everything he does it the way he wants. Na'am. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala yakhtabiru al-ibada. Allah tests his creation. Bi anwa'i al-balaya wal-masa'ib. He tests his creation with different types of calamities. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. He controls this world the way he wills. So he's praiseworthy for all of that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. So we praise him for his names. We praise him for his characteristics. We also praise him for how he controls this universe, how he brings in things into existence, and how he takes things out of this world. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, he's praiseworthy for that. So that is the universal rulings and judgments that he does. And the Sheikh goes on to say,
وَأَحْكَامِ الشَّرْعِيَّةِ الشَّامِلَةِ لِكُلِّ مَشْرُوعٍ.
And now, the second type of ahkam is what? The first one is ahkam al-qadariyya. This one is ahkam al-shar'iyya. He's also praised. Again, the wow is connected to what? He's also praised for what? He's also praised, subhanahu wa ta'ala, in that which he legislated from the religion. Ahkam shar'iyya. Allah gives rulings which are legislations in the religion. In which he did what? In which he sent it to us in this book. Everything is clear to mankind. Tabarak wa ta'ala. It's a legislation which the Sheikh said, ashamila. It's so comprehensive. It takes on everything. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, this legislation he gave us, this book he gave us, it deals with matters that was at the time of the messenger and that which will be until the day of judgment. As Allah said in the Quran, وَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْكَ الْكِتَابَ تِبْيَانًا لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ Surah An-Nahl, ayah 89. We have sent on you, Muhammad, a book that clarifies everything for you. It what? It clarifies every single thing that you need. It is clear there. So everything that we need. فَمَا مِنْ شَيْءٍ There is not a matter. إِلَّا وَفِي شَرْعِ اللَّهِ Except in the legislations of Allah, there's a law passed that we can find in it. So he's praiseworthy for that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam.
وأحكام الجائز بالثواب
وأحكام الجزاء
وأحكام الجزاء بالثواب للمحسنين والعقاب للمجرمين.
Allah تبارك وتعالى is also praised for what? وأحكام laws, ها أحكام rulings on based on what? By rewarding good for the good doers. الجزاء بالثواب للمحسنين. The people who do good, who follow his command, who stay away from his prohibitions. Ha, as he said in Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Surah Al-Infitar, Ayah 13 to Ayah 14, what did Allah say? Inna al-abrara lafi na'im, wa inna al-fujara lafi jahim. That the righteous ones, the good doers, the ones who follow the command of their Lord, the way he legislated it, those people, for them is what? Those people, lafi na'im, they are in the blessings of Allah, Jannatul Firdaus. Wa innal fujara, the criminals, the wrongdoers, those who went against Allah's commands, where are they? Lafi jahim, and they're in the hellfire. Praises to him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, who has made reward for the good doers, and who has also made punishment for the criminals and the wrongdoers. So this statement of the sheikh is bara'atul istihlal. You can already sense from his introduction that usul al-fiqh is what? It is ahkam. Ahkam qadariyya going to be dealt in it. Ahkam al-shar'iyya. Ahkam al-jaza'i wa thawab. All of them, they come either directly or indirectly in usul al-fiqh. Na'am.
وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له في الأسماء والصفات والعبادة والأحكام.
The sheikh رحمه الله said وأشهد. ما معنى وأشهد؟ It means أقر I affirm. أشهد means أقر I affirm. What is he affirming? لا إله إلا الله. What does لا إله إلا الله mean? أن الله the Allah هو المستحق للعبادة وحده. Allah is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. That's what I affirm. I believe that. I testify to that. That he, subhanahu wa ta'ala, is the only one who deserves to be worshipped. And I, وَلِذَٰلِكَ لَأَتَوَجَّهُ. And because of that, I will not direct myself to what? Any individual in my worship other than him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My salah is for him. My oath is for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Na'am. My prostration is for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. My supplication and my dua is for him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمُ دُعُونِي أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي سَيَدْخُلُونَ جَهَنَّمَ دَاخِلِينَ. In ayah 60, Surah Ghafir, وَقَالَ رَبُّكُمْ, your Lord has said, أُدْعُونِي, ask me, supplicate to me, أَسْتَجِبْ لَكُمْ, I will accept your supplication. After Allah, what is he talking about? Dua. Then Allah, after that, he says, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ يَسْتَكْبِرُونَ عَنْ عِبَادَتِي, those who are arrogant for my supplication. So dua is supplication. Dua is what? Supplication. You can't divert it for anybody other than Allah. Because the ayah in the first part, it says, أُدْعُونِي, call on to me, supplicate to me. And then at the ending, what is Allah saying? عِبَادَتِي. So based on the ayah, that the dua is a ibadah. It can't be diverted for anybody else. So when you say ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wahdahu la sharika lah, you're saying all of my ibadat. Ibadah is what? Ismun jami' li kulli ma yuhibbuhu Allah wa yarda min al aqwali wal a'mal al zahirati wal batinah. General term, everything that which Allah is happy, he's pleased with, subhanahu wa ta'ala, that which is apparent and that which is external, whether it's a speech or an action. That's the definition of ibadah. Then the sheikh said, لا شريك له. Allah تبارك وتعالى, he has no partners. He has no partners, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. له في الأسماء والصفات. In his names and not in his characteristics. Allah doesn't have partners. So pay attention to this. Three things we believe Allah doesn't have partners. No one shares with these three. Allah, no one shares his rububiyyah with him. No one shares his uluhiyyah with him. And no one shares his asma' wa sifat with him. He's munfarid. He's alone in all of that. That's why we do tawheed. We single Allah in all of those three. In rububiyyah, in uluhiyyah, and in asma' wa sifat. He's all alone in that. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wal ibadah, in his worship. Wal ahkam, in the legislation. We believe Allah is the only legislator. He is the only one who legislates. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, as he said, in al-hukmu illa lillah. Legislation is only for Allah. وَلَا يُشْرِكُ فِي حُكْمِهِ أَحَدًا. Allah does not bring into his legislation anybody. No one shares Allah's legislation with him. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is min khasa'isih. He's specific in this. Subhanahu wa ta'ala. Naam.
وَأَشْهَدُ أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا عَبْدُهُ وَرَسُولُهُ الَّذِي بَيَّنَ الْحُكْمَ وَالْأَحْكَامَ
الَّذِي بَيَّنَ الْحِكَمَ
الَّذِي بَيَّنَ الْحُكْمَ
It says الحكم
الحكم والحكمة الحكمة والأحكام
What does it say?
الحكمة
Change it to حكم نعم Because أحكام is the plural of حكم حكم is the singular of أحكام So what's the point of repeating it twice?
نعم
So حكم is wisdoms Is what?
Wisdom
The wisdoms نعم So the sheikh said, وَأَشْهَدُ I testify أَنَّ مُحَمَّدًا Muhammad عَبْدُهُ is his slave. وَرَسُولُهُ and his messenger. Pay attention. Nabiullahi Muhammad is between two stages. He has not reached uluhiyya. He's not an ilah. And he also hasn't reached what? He also is not a normal creation of Allah. He is a rasul, a messenger sent from Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. So we believe that Muhammad is a slave and a messenger. He's a slave, hasn't reached Allah's status. He's also a messenger. He's not a normal slave of Allah. We place him in that place, in that which Allah placed him, subhanahu wa ta'ala. Also, the sheikh then says, the one who clarified the wisdoms of every ruling. The Prophet ﷺ, he explained it to us. Wal ahkama and the laws. The Prophet told us, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us some of the wisdoms behind some laws. He told us it. And he also told us the rulings in every matter that we need. Every matter that we're in need of, the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam conveyed it. Salawatullahi wa sallam alayhi. The Prophet, what did he say in the hadith? مَا بَعَثَ اللَّهُ نَبِيًّا Allah has not sent a messenger إِلَّا كَانَ حَقًّا عَلَيْهِ أَن يَدُلَّ أُمَّتَهُ عَلَى خَيْرِ مَا يَعْلَمُهُ اللَّهُ That Allah has not sent a prophet, except it was obligatory on him and a duty for him to convey everything he knew that was good for the people, for him to convey it. And he did that. And every evil that the ummah may suffer from, it was an obligatory duty on the messenger to convey the people to, that matter and for them to know it. Naam.
وَأَصَلَّ الْأُصُولَ وَفَصَّلَهَا
The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, does he not say وضح الحلال والحرام?
وضح الحلال والحرام.
He clarified the halal and the haram, our messenger.
وأصل الأصول وفصلها.
He sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he explained the fundamental matters of the sharia. He told it to us alayhi salatu wasalam. And he also explained it. He told us the fundamental things. وَفَصَّلَهَا Tafsil means what? It is to clarify the matter. So he solidified the rulings and he also expanded and he explained it and he told us what it is. عليه الصلاة والسلام. Because the ayah came down. الْيَوْمَ يَئِسَ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا مِن دِينِكُمْ فَلَا تَخْشَوْهُمْ وَخْشَوْنِي الْيَوْمَ أَكْمَلْتُ لَكُمْ دِينَكُمْ وَأَتْمَمْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ نِعْمَتِي وَرَضِيْتُ لَكُمُ الْإِسْلَامَ دِينًا نعم
حتى استتم هذا الدين واستقام.
The religion became complete, which was that day. اليوم أكملت لكم دينكم وأتممت عليكم نعمتي ورضيت لكم الإسلام دينا. The religion became complete. Everything was clarified, and he صلى الله عليه وسلم, Allah took him from the creation. The sheikh went on saying,
اللهم صل وسلم على محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه وأتباعه. خصوص العلماء الأعلام.
The Sheikh said, Allahumma, oh Allah. Allahumma, oh Allah. The word Allahumma comes from Ya Allah. That's what it means. Allahumma means Ya Allah. It's calling out to Allah. Salli. Salli means what? Now, Salli is an Amr, right? Can we say that we are ordering Allah to do Salli of the Prophet? Now, you have to learn this. When a person who is low talks to the person who is higher than him, there's a, what is it called? It's called dua. When we tell, when we use amar, it's not, we don't call it amar, we call it dua. But when Allah says it to us, we call it what? Amar. And inshallah ta'ala, we're going to expand on that later. So when we say Allahumma salli, even though it's a fi'il amar, but it's a dua. Oh Allah, send salutation on the Messenger of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It's a request. It's a supplication. What does salah mean? Salah means, as we said, the qawla of Abi Aliya is what we take, is thana'uh, Allah praises him, fil mala'il a'la, in the high above. Salam means what? Peace. Both of them are combined in one ayah. So the believer should say both of them. Inna Allah wa malaikatahu yusalluna ala nabi. Yusalluna ala nabi. Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu sallu alayhi wa sallimu taslima. So you combine the two. You combine the two. The sheikh said, oh Allah, send salutation and peace on the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَعَلَىٰ آلِهِ and his family. اِخْتُلِفَ, the scholars disputed what is meant by آل. Four views are taken what آل means. Four views. عَلَىٰ أَرْبَعَةِ أَقْوَالِ. Four views. The first view is what? The first view is that the آل, the family is هُمُ الَّذِينَ حُرِمَتْ عَلِهِمُ الصَّدَقَةِ. It is the ones that the sadaqah was made haram from them. And we've explained that in our book أُرْجُوزَةُ الْمِئِيَّةِ في ذكر حال أشرف البرية. When we were talking about the Prophet's biography, we explained it there. That who are the ones that the Sadaqah has made haram from them? Was Bani Abd and Hashim and Muttalib. Only. From the children of Abd Manaf, only Hashim and Muttalib are the only two that the Sadaqah was made haram from them. You see, that view, that the first qawl, it is clearly mansus, it's clearly taken from Imam Shafi'i. He took that view, and Imam Muhammad took that view. And the majority, it is the majority of the view of وَهُوَاخْتِيَارُ جُمْهُورِ أَصْحَابِ أَحْمَدُ وَالشَّافِعِي. It is the view of the majority of the madhab of Imam Abu Hani, Imam Ahmed, and Imam al-Shafi'i. The second view is, it is his lineage and his wife specifically. It's specifically his what? It's specifically his wives and his lineage, anyone who came from his lineage. And that's the view taken by Ibn Abd al-Barr in his Kitab al-Tamhid. The third view is his followers. Anyone who follows him, alayhi salatu wasalam, are from his al, hum atba'uhu. They're the followers of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam ila qiyam al-sa'ah, until the Day of Judgment. That is the view that was mentioned by Ibn Abd al-Barr. Some of the scholars, he said in his Kitab al-Tamhid. The fourth one is who? It is humul atqiya'i min ummati. It's the only the pious people of this ummah. And this is the view taken by who? Qadi Hussein, al-Raghib al-Asbahani, and other groups of scholars. That's the view they take. That's the view in which they take. Naam. And his ashab is who? Ashab is meant by man laqiya an-nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallama. Ashab is anyone who met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallama mu'minan bih wa mata ala al-Islam. It's anyone who met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallama and they died upon Islam. So we don't say anybody who saw the Prophet, because some of the Sahabas were blind. So you have to say those who met the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallama. And wa atba'uh, his atba'ahu, هم الذين صاروا على طريقته. They are the ones who followed the Prophet's path, عليه الصلاة والسلام. Anyone who followed him. نعم. Then the Sheikh said, وخصوصا, specifically the علماء. خصوصا العلماء الأعلام. And specifically the scholars. The scholars. And this goes hand in hand with the statement of Allah تبارك وتعالى that the Sheikh is doing here. والذين جاءوا من بعدهم يقولون ربنا اغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم. That he's acknowledging the status and the rights that the ulama have on us and that which they have put forward for us. نعم.
أما بعد.
To proceed. The Sheikh said أما بعد, to proceed. So to proceed أما بعد, it's انتقال من أسلوب إلى آخر. أما بعد means what? It is to move from one type of speech to another. So he's trying to say, after everything I have said, which is Basmala, the Hamdala, the Shahada on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the Shahadatain, and also the Salah on the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and also on the believers and everyone. After all of that, to proceed, I am now going to say to you guys what I want to say. Naam.
فهذه رسالة لطيفة في أصول الفقه.
The word أما بعد, the fa has to be always used after it, because it's the jawab, the answer to it. نعم. أما بعد. ها أما بعد. Hey, when we were studying our كتاب قطر الندى وبل الصدى, we took the situations that the word بعد comes into, right? We took that situation that the word ba'du comes into. Two hala, ba'du and ba'da, qablu. We took it. So here, the word ba'du, its situation we took in our sharah al-qatru, al-nada wa ballu al-sada. So we won't confuse the listeners. فَهَذِهِ جَوَابُ الشَّرْطِ جَوَابُ The jawab, sorry, not jawab al-shart. The jawab of the sentence. To proceed. فَهَذِهِ this. Now this هذه is a pro, it's a ضمير. Sorry, it's not a ضمير, it's اسم إشارة. هذه is a what? It's a اسم إشارة. This. Now what's the sheikh pointing towards? The scholars, they say one of two. هذه is a اسم إشارة. It either is that the sheikh is pointing towards the book that he, if he wrote the introduction first, and he didn't write the book yet, and he started from the introduction and then he's writing the book, then how is he saying hadihi this? What is he pointing at? Because the book is not even written yet. So some scholars, they say it is manwiyun, he's talking about what he's going to write. He already knows it's ready in his brain. Or sometimes what scholars do is they write their book first and then after that they write the introduction. So then it becomes something which is mahsus. He's actually talking about the book. Whichever of it, for hadihi goes back to that. So it's a ismu ishara, the sheikh is pointing at it. Risalatun, it's a risala, it's a little essay. Latifatun means good. So latifa is something very, mashallah, good. In what? Fi usulil fiqh. It's in this field, usulil fiqh. It's written in the what? It's written in this field, usul al fiqh. Naam.
Sahlatul alfadhi.
Ma ma'ana sahlatul alfadh? It means its wordings are simple. It means mafhumatul alfadh. It's easy for you to understand what the words are. They're very simple. I've used very simple terminologies, not too much complicated words. Naam.
وَاضِحَةُ الْمَعَانِي.
Its meanings are very clear. Naam.
مُعِينَةٌ عَلَى تَعَلَّمَ الْأَحْكَامِ.
عَلَى تَعَلُّمِ.
عَلَى تَعَلُّمِ الْأَحْكَامِ لِكُلِّ مُتَأَمِّلٍ مَعَانِي.
Naam. So the sheikh said, mu'inatun, one that supports. Mu'ina means is to help you. That helps you on what? Ala ta'allumi, learning, in learning al-ahkam, the rulings, likulli, for everyone, muta'ammilin, who's observing. Observing what? It's ma'ani, its meanings. Anyone who is observing the what? Who's observing the meaning that are in it. Naam.
Nas'alullaha.
We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, as a whole, all of us, we ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala. Naam.
نسأل الله أن ينفعه.
That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He benefits. We ask Allah that He benefits. Naam.
بها جامعها.
The person who brought it together.
وقارئها.
So who's the one who brought it together? He himself. وقارئها is the one who reads it. We ask Allah tabarak wa ta'ala to benefit the one who brought it together. Jami' is a person who compiles something together. So he didn't even say the one who authored it. He said, I just compiled. Humility. Humbleness. Then I only compiled what the ulama said. Naam. Wa qari'aha, and the one who reads it. May Allah tabarak wa ta'ala benefit him. Naam.
Innahu jawadun kareem.
Allah is one who is generous and jawad, who gives. Allah is very generous and a giver. One who gives, subhanahu wa ta'ala.